Hi there, my name is Thomas. Today I will show you how to price a non-callable mortgage back bond on the Black-Derman-Toy ladder. I will show you how to calculate OAS and also show how OAS changes impacts the price. This video and the Excel worksheet, including all underlying VBA coding, are available on investmentexcel.com and spotafile.com. All right, let's move on. Before showing the cash flow structure of the non-callable bond and its pricing, I will just shortly touch upon the Black-Derman-Toy model. It should be noted that in another session I have demonstrated more in detail the BDT model, so please refer to this session if you'd like. But the basic principles are these: a stochastic interest rate model with a time-dependent drift and a time-dependent volatility. It's a process of the short interest rates that are log normal. So the model is calibrated to exclude negative rates in the future. Not that it's such a big issue today as it was 30 years ago when the model was built, but back then no one believed that rates could be negative. But as you may know or might know, many rates today, even on longer maturity bonds, they are in negative territory. The distribution, statistical distribution of the BDT model is rather nasty, but luckily there is a nice discrete counterpart that can be applied when using the model in practice, in pricing, and in theoretical demonstrations. The applied model looks like this, again with a parameterization that is time dependent, both in drift and in volatility. Okay, the idea behind the BDT model is basically to build a number of stochastic interest rate path into the future. Originally, of course, a continuous number, but here a discrete number of path. But under the condition or constraint so that pricing any zero coupon security on the final chosen rates will give the exact price of the zero coupon bond price today. So this is where the label no-arbitrage free model comes in, or no-arbitrage model comes in. It's a price, or it's a model where the observed zero coupon yield today, zero coupon bond, can be priced from an arbitrarily chosen path of zero coupon rates in the domain. So this particular feature makes it very interesting to use in practice, because at least you are sure today that the structure of the rates are calibrated so that they give the exact price today. The calibration is done on both the observed prices of the zero coupon bonds, or their yields, their implicit yields, or on the volatility structure, which can be observed as well in the market. Normally, in practice, the volatility is assumed constant through time, that is sigma in the applied discretized version is 0.1, but of course still there is evolution at every time, because the the total drift or the sorry the total volatility is scaled in the state, the S state here. So the volatility along with the state number is governing the spikes up and down. All right. So what we have to do now is to make the calibration, and I will just create a disequilibrium so we can see the change. We need to calculate the zero coupon bond prices observed on this initially chosen set of yields, or short rates, or we can use what is called a forward induction method, where we calculate state prices on each node. It's a rather simple technique, and it's a very, very fast technique. It might not be as intuitive as calculating every bond and making sure by trial and error that the yield structure fits the pricing. But I will stick to this model and just show here how it works. We have the observed spot prices, so the underlying prices behind the structure. We have the present value of the model calculated zero coupon bonds, and this is found by taking the sum of all state prices at each maturity. So now what we just need to do is to try to minimize the difference between all these sets by changing the drift parameter A up here. And this is exactly where this time dependency come into play. It makes us able to make the calibration to the observed bond price. Taking the squared differences, summing, we have the residual square error here, and let's just try to minimize that by changing all the A's. This one is not, this one should not be changed, because the 2% is given as we start, because it's observed. Let's calibrate. Okay, and we immediately go down to see the difference squared. I can, it's hard to see here because it's squared, but here we see that, yeah, let's just call it zero. So there should be a fit. And how can we make sure there is a fit? One way of doing it is just, yeah, we can see here the difference in yields. That's a slight difference from 100% zero, but doesn't matter, is it as good as it gets? Let's just try to price a 10-year zero coupon bond. And this is now priced on the lattice using the short rates and not using the price of the bond. So we use the short rates this time to discount with a backwards method. I'll just show that. So let's just take a principal of one, so we get the discount factor and 0.65. And where does that come from? Always when you build financial products, or when you price financial products, you start by building the tree, and then you set up the cash flow, the expected cash flow of the product. In this case, it's a 10-year zero, so we have ones over here, just one in principle, zero everywhere, and then we just start the trivial work of discounting every single note. So this one is the price calculated as the expected value of the up and down, discounted backwards with the corresponding zero rate up here, and just noting that the expectations here, they are formed under the risk neutral measure, which is underlying in the BDT. So in this case, we use 50% of up and down, and we do that all the way, and we get a zero, a 10-year zero on this price. And let's just see that this price corresponds to the observed 4.25. I can do that by inverting the price and lifting it to the 1/10. Oh, there's a problem here. There. So it should be, yeah, let's hope there's 2.5 here. Yeah. So it works. Another way I can show something interesting is to take a coupon bond, say a 10-year, 6% principal 100 coupon bond. It's priced at 116 in the ladder. But if this coupon bond is not a government bond issue, there is a risk premium. So in this case, for instance, if the market price is 102, it's lower than the one implied by the risk-free rates, what is then the demanded risk premium? It's 1.72, which is the spread, the set spread or OAS spread. So this the level that is added to each zero coupon yield, or what is the same, to each state interest rate. So we see down here, it was 2% before, now it's 1.72. So this was one way of pricing it. We can price this product the usual way, without using the tree, of course. The tree is merely for illustrative purposes in this situation here. It's because we are going to use it in session with both callable bond pricing and option bond pricing, European and European bond pricing. If we just price this on the curve as we normally would do, we would just set up the cash flow again all the way down. And then we will just discount with the, or we'll just price it using the discount factors and the cash flows. So I will take here the cash flow or the discount factor. Should give us, so now we have all the discount factors, and then what I would do, of course, was just to multiply each cash flow with its corresponding discount factor. And for this purpose, I can use the sum product function, and hopefully this would give us not 102 but 116, because this is priced on the zero coupon, the risk-free curve, so it's when the rate is zero. So why have I done all this exercise with building the rates in notes and so on? Yes, because we're gonna use it when pricing more sophisticated financial products. Yeah, as I said, like options and also path dependent products. So, but that was an introduction to how to price on a binomial lattice. and in this case the Black-Derman-Toy lattice. Thank you very much for listening.